Hi everybody. I plopped myself to bed and realized, crap, I haven't done an update. So it's the 18th of May and it rained all bloody day. I had a doctor's appointment this morning in another town, just outside of the city. And then I had to go to the lab after that, and it took like nearly 2 hours to get my lab work done, which was kind of crazy. By the time I got back here to the hotel, my feet were soaking wet, so I put my shoes in the dryer. 'Cause, I packed for like 4 days worth of staying. This is when I first came to the city. I also did not pack for winter or rain or anything. Anyway, so put my shoes in the dryer here at the hotel and spent $3 to do that so I could. And I was anxious because I wanted to get over to the hospital. I get over to the hospital, and they had my feet were once again soaking wet from nice and dry to just absolutely soaking wet because it was raining so hard. I had actually bought an umbrella, a two-person umbrella, so I would have more coverage, and took that to the hospital. Got to the hospital, and Mike is like unresponsive. He's just like so out of it. And then the nurse kind of tells me towards the end of her shift, yeah, we gave him a little bit extra today when we were turning him or whatever. And I'm like, oh, thanks. That's okay. I spent 4.5-ish hours there today talking at Mike while he just lays there, gob open. Like, totally not at home. Just out. Kind of freaked me out a little bit, but the bleeding had stopped or at least slowed down to like fairly insignificant amounts. They restarted the heparin. Things have been going good that way. Then one of the nurses said to me, well, not so much, not, too much going on today. She said, the x-ray showed some improvement in the lungs. I'm like, what? What do you mean? She said, like I said, did they do an x-ray today? She said, no. She said, maybe last night. And then she asked the others, no, it was like yesterday morning. And I was like, I was there for that x-ray. Like, I was standing in the room. And I thought that the x-ray had come back that there wasn't any improvement. So I don't know if, like, the preliminary report was that, and then the final report was that there was some small minor improvement or whatever. But you know what? I'll take that. That just made me happy. And then the ECMO specialist said that she had turned down the ECMO today by a little bit. So again, another gain. Yay. I actually wanted to jump, show me jumping around in here and having a celebration, but I'm way too tired for that. Spent the whole time on the unit with like sopping wet feet. And so when I got back, well, okay, so I posted on Facebook, any of my Edmonton friends have like wellies and a raincoat I could borrow? Because I didn't come prepared at all for any kind of weather other than good, I guess, and didn't plan on buying a whole new wardrobe. So Danica came to the rescue, but left the things at the hotel, and I was already at the hospital by that point. And then the rain changed to full on blizzard conditions, and certainly, even though Danica had dropped off, rubber boots and a rain jacket, at the hotel, I still wasn't prepared for winter, so. I walked back with my wet shoes, not enough clothes on, was not very, and in the blizzard was not pleasant at all. Plus, they, when shift change happened for evenings, like from day shift to night shift, they moved Mike around a lot, and he actually then opened his eyes and stuff, and I'm like, damn it, pardon me, darn it, sorry. Of course, you'd just be like conked all day, and then when I'm gonna leave, you're gonna wake up. That's great. But I think he'll just have a night's sleep. He was still like severely, severely out of it. So, anyway, I will take that. Yeah, that's really about it for the update for today. Mean, there's a few medical things that they did, but I don't really need to mention those because they're kind of neither here nor there. Still don't know about this monoclonal antibody. Research. It's not a. It's not an immunosuppressant like it sounded like. I talked to the researcher today, the actual researcher who, sorry, who informed me that it is a monoclonal antibody specifically targeting receptors in the lungs. The problem with the study is that, I mean, like everything else, there's risk, right? Like everything we do. So what do? We get caught up in fear and get caught up on the risk. The other piece is that it's a double-blind study, so meaning when the IV bag arrives on the unit, we wouldn't know whether Mike's getting the drug or a placebo. So I have to think about that too, and I really was hoping to ask him what his thoughts were on it, but he just doesn't seem to want to wake up enough when I'm there, so I don't know. I don't know. So and I'm hoping to get to the hospital by 9 in the morning tomorrow, but depending on the blizzard conditions, I guess it's supposed to snow all night and all tomorrow, I think, in Edmonton, so that'll be fantastic. I think that's all for now because I'm super tired. But I had a really couple really great talks with fabulous, fabulous beings today who just wanted to offer me encouragement. And little Miss Danica for coming to my rescue. So thank you, love. I love you very much for that. So now should it stop snowing, I'll have rain gear. And she bought me a fuzzy, really fuzzy warm blanket and I guess because my videos really suck, she bought me like this tripod thingy for my phone, but it doesn't fit my phone. It might have actually took the case off. So maybe I'll do that and see if I can better my sucky videos. But I'm not here to be a YouTuber. I'm just here to give you guys information. I think that's about all that I can think of at the moment. Yeah. Anyway, as I mentioned, had some really great encouragement from some really amazing individuals. And the nurses, tonight, one in particular, don't, you know, meant you. I'm not gonna put her name out there, but just she almost brings tears to my eyes every time I see her because she's so kind, just so lovely, and really cares about her patients and cares about their family. And, she wasn't Mike's nurse tonight, but bothered to come over to talk to me to see how I was doing and ask me if I'm getting rest and if I'm eating and stuff. And yeah, Mike's in some really good hands, honestly. Anyway, I love you all and keep your loved ones close. Let them know that you love them. Stay safe. Get vaccinated. Stay warm. Stay off the roads. And we'll see you tomorrow. Good night.